Hello and welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Mandy. How are you today? I hope you're fine, okay? So, for my returning subscribers, wow, I always say thank you. God bless you for always turning back to this channel, for always coming back to watch my videos. I'm so grateful. God bless you real good. And for those of you who are viewing me for the very first time, what can I say? I love you, but God loves you more, okay? So you're my first time viewer, and I want you to know that for you to be part of this family, you have to do what? Just hit that subscribe button for us, okay? Then turn on the notification bell, so that each time we upload a video like this, you will be the first to be notified. Also, like my videos, share my videos, and comment on the videos. Ask me questions, okay? Comment. I need your comments, okay? Your comments will make me woo, and God bless you real, real good, all right? So in today's video, I'll be talking about what? Another powerful cleansing. Are you interested in knowing another powerful cleansing you need to do to remove what? Negativity out of your life, to remove any form of negative energies, to remove evil activities in your life. If you're interested in knowing this, then you have to stay with me to the end of this video as we dive into the video proper. Welcome back into our channel, okay? So I said we'll be talking about what? Another powerful cleanser today. Another way you can remove what? Negativity out of your life. Another way you can cleanse yourself out of negative vibes, out of negative auras. Remember, the spiritual controls the physical, okay? Whatever that happens to us in the physical has already taken place in the spiritual, okay? And now it is wise, or it is good for you as a child of God to do what? To always cleanse yourself at least every week, to remove negative energies. What are these negative energies? The negative energies is that it's not only when you're attacked by witchcraft or by any witches. Negative energy is that each time you go out, you meet people, and everybody you meet come with their own energy. And as you come close to them, maybe you hug some, you shake hands with some, you laugh with some, you are attracting different kind of energy to yourself. Some of them can be negative, some of them can be positive, okay? So it is advisable for you to do what? To cleanse yourself, to remove those negative vibes you have contacted from people as you go out daily, all right? So, and negative energies can also mean maybe witchcraft in the environment you're living. Maybe there is evil things going on around where you're living, or maybe you have spiritual attack even in your own home, okay? So with this cleansing now, you will be free from all that, all right? So in this video, I'll be telling us just two things we'll be needing to do what? To carry out this powerful cleanser. As we all know, we know bitterleaf is number one ingredient to be needing to carry out this powerful cleansing. Then the second ingredient to be needing is what? Scentleaf. Okay, we all know scentleaf. Scentleaf is called in Chanwe Nibo language, so I don't know the name they call it in Yoruba language or in Hausa language, okay? Amibo, and so the name is in Chanwe, or the general name, if you go to the market, just ask them to give you scentleaf as well as bitterleaf. Bitterleaf is a general name for everybody, okay? Now, when you have gotten these two things, you have to get what? Your sea salt. The sea salt is the third ingredient we'll be needing here. I talk more about sea salt because sea salt has this efficacy. It has this spiritual element in it, property in it. It is very potent when you use it to carry out any kind of spiritual work, okay? But when you mention it, some people begin to feel that maybe you just want it to talk about it because you sell it also. It's not because I do sell sea salt. It's because I have tested it and I know it is powerful when it comes to our spiritual work, okay? Now, when you have gotten your sea salt, the next thing you're going to do is to do what? Is to get a bucket of water. Now, this cleansing is for those of you who are experiencing failure, okay? If you are somebody that maybe when you are called for a job, when you get there, suddenly things will turn against you. You understand, everybody is going in, and when you get to your own turn, things will just turn around. That this video is for you, and this cleansing is for you, okay? If you're someone that's experiencing disappointment, they will call you for you see an opening and you submit your CV there, and when you get there, before you know, they say they have taken somebody else just a day before you came. You understand? If you're someone that is experiencing that kind of disappointment, maybe people will promise you things and they will not get back to you. Wow, it's so hurtful, it's so painful to find out that maybe somebody has promised you something and suddenly he says, begin to tell you squawk and bone stories, okay? It's not something that is natural. So if you are experiencing this kind of thing, this cleansing is for you. Now, if you're somebody that is experiencing what's bitterness, anywhere you go, people will just hate you for no reason. They will see you, they will just dislike you. You are even trying to please them, but they will not like you. You try your best to make sure they are happy with you, but they will just find a fault in you, that there is a spirit, there is a power behind it. You have to do this cleansing. Are you experiencing close to success syndrome? Wow, these are the special people that I'm interested in, because okay, I've experienced it in the past. Okay, now, if you're experiencing close to success syndrome, is a situation whereby you do what? You are close to a particular thing. You are seeing this thing that it has worked out. You already smile and say, wow, I appreciate it. I know this thing has worked out already. And before you know it, within a twinkle of an eye, it will cut off. That is what they call close to success syndrome. You are already rejoicing that this thing has worked out for you. And before you know it, maybe a business proposal, you are rejoicing that maybe that business, they will give it to you, the contract, they will give it to you. And suddenly you find out that they are giving it to someone else. That is what is called close to success syndrome. Even if they did not give it to someone else, maybe you find out that the business, suddenly they say they are no more interested to do it. They call that close to success syndrome. Now, are you experiencing setback also? Okay, so all these people are in the category of people that will be needing to do what? This powerful cleansing. Now, I said you need your bitterleaf, your scentleaves, and your salt. Okay, please try to use your sea salt to do this cleansing. Okay, now when you get your bitterleaf and your scentleaf, all you have to do is to boil enough water, boil water in a very big pot. You are going to boil water in a very big pot, okay? Because this water you're boiling, you are going to use it to bathe. You are not going to add any cold water into that water. You are going to bathe with it just the way you boiled it, okay? And that is why I ask, or I say, that you need to boil enough water in a very big pot. Okay, now when you boil this water, you're going to add your bitter leaf and your scent leaf into that water. Now when you have washed it and added it into it, you have to allow it to boil for 20 to 30 minutes. Okay, now after boiling for 20 to 30 minutes, what is the next thing you're going to do? You're going to remove it from the fire and allow it to cool. All right, if you're somebody that bathes warm water, you know, you check it, if it's warm enough for you to use it and cleanse, you carry it and go and cleanse. And if you're somebody that bathes with cool water, you allow it to cool very well before you use it. Okay, now remember, when you're about to carry out this cleansing, you are not going to need soap and you're not going to use any sponge. In this cleansing, you are not using soap or sponge. You are just going to cleanse like that. So therefore, you can even bathe an hour before the time you want to do this cleansing. You can bathe, maybe if you are somebody in the night that you cannot bathe, you can't stay without bathing with soap, what you have to do is to do what? Get your bath by maybe 8 in the night. Then after bathing, okay, then 1 hour later, maybe around 10, you have to do what? Prepare this cleansing. You don't need soap, you don't need any sponge. All you need to do is to carry the water, then declare your intentions. You have to pray. You have to tell God why you're doing this cleansing. You have to tell God to remove negativity from your life, that you want him to remove setback. You want him to remove failure. You want him to remove close to success syndrome. Anything that make you to have disfavor, that he wants him to remove it through this cleansing. Remember, herbs are powerful, okay? And God has given us all these herbs and leaves to use as a gift to humanity. Now, when you speak to them, they hear you because they have spirits behind them, okay? So you have to do what? Speak and tell God that as you're using this herb to bait, these leaves to bait, you declare that anything that is, you know what you're facing, you know what you're passing through. If yours is failure, disappointment, hatred, unnecessary hatred, you mention it, that as you cleanse, you remove it out of your life. You send it back to the sender. You understand? Then after praying that way, you are going to command the good things you want to see into your life. You're going to say, from today, as I have cleansed, I welcome favor. I welcome
goodness. I welcome acceptance. I welcome attraction, positive attraction. You know, you begin to say what you declare, what you want to see in your life. Remember, the Bible said that there is power in our tongue, and whatever he hears you say, according to Numbers 14 verse 20, this is my favorite scripture, Numbers 14 28, he said that he will do it for you, whatever he hears you say in his ear. So as you have welcomed those sweetness into your life, that is how it will be for you. Okay, now for people that are into a kind of you have cleansed, or you are not feeling anything but you just want to remove negative energy because you come in contact with people every day, you have to do what? Do it at least once in a week. Okay, but for people that it's, you know, there's something you experience, you have to do it straight away for 7 days. You have to do this minimum 7 days so that you can remove those accumulated negative energies. All right, so that is just it. I will end this video here so that some people will not complain of data. Okay, so this is the end of this video. Expect another powerful video from me. Do what? Expect another powerful video from me, but don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that we can move together. Okay, thank you so much, and God bless you. See you in my next video. Bye.